Facebook tries to be Yelp, YouTube goes after Spotify, and Sony creates its own TV service. I'm Bridget Carey, and this is your CNET Update. Facebook is trying to simplify privacy settings. The network launched a new page called Privacy Basics. It has all the same privacy settings as before, but now the font is really big, and you can slowly click through a guide to learn about each setting. Because I guess larger fonts make you feel safer? Facebook is likely doing this because most people don't trust Facebook with their data. Well, they don't trust any communication company, really. A recent Pew Research study says 9 out of 10 Americans believe they have no control over personal information and how it's collected and used by companies. While Facebook tries to clean up its reputation on privacy, it also launched a new page that competes with Yelp. It's called Facebook Places, and you can search for things to do in any city. It highlights restaurants, hotels, attractions, and entertainment. And with those places, you also see the mentions and photos of those places taken by your friends. Right now, it's not very good on mobile. It's easier to use on your desktop browser. Twitter announced it'll be making changes over the coming months. It'll have easier ways to share video, and there will be more options to make a private comment on a public conversation. And to help you feel like you're not missing out, it'll show you some tweets you missed while offline, because Twitter tracks what you click to guess what tweets you may like to see. Truth is, Twitter's a messy, complicated network to learn if you're new at it, and there's so much noise it can feel too busy to follow everything. People use other services like TweetDeck to manage the Twitter madness. I'm not sure if these small changes will be enough to keep users and bring in new ones, but it is a start. In other news, Sony unveiled details about its online TV service called PlayStation View. It'll roll out with about 75 channels with programs from major networks and local broadcast stations, and you don't need cable or satellite subscriptions to watch. It's the first multi-channel television service that runs completely over the internet. But we don't know how much it'll cost per month. More details will come when it launches early next year. And YouTube is launching its own streaming music service for music videos. It's called YouTube Music Key, and on Monday, you can get it for about $10 a month. Right now, YouTube is the number one site for people to go to for listening to music, but if you pay, there are no ads and you can stream offline. Another bonus, paying for Google Play Music streaming also gets you access to YouTube's Music Key and vice versa, so it's a two-for-one. That's your tech news update. There's always more at CNET.com. From our studios in New York, I'm Bridget Carey.